Coming up on this edition of Out of the Blue from Middle Tennessee State University, we have a conversation with the campus icon, Dr. Terry Whiteside, about his decades of service to our university, most recently as the Dean of the College of Behavioral and Health Sciences. We update you about our Blue Raider Athletic Association and our plans to increase fan engagement and involvement. And we introduce you to Linda Olsen, our Director of Undergraduate Admissions, and talk about our efforts to recruit great students. I'm Andrew Oppmann, and this is Out of the Blue. Welcome to Out of the Blue. I'm Andrew Oppmann. Dr. Terry Whiteside, Dean of the College of Behavioral and Health Sciences, has been called the campus icon here for very good reasons. He's been MTSU's man about campus for almost 45 years. Now, if you're an alumnus of this institution, the odds are pretty good you've had some connection to Dr. Whiteside, given his high-profile academic, administrative, and athletic roles he's held in his distinguished career. Welcome to Out of the Blue, to the campus icon.
Thanks, Andrew. You made me sound good right there.
Well, I tell you what, it's easy to make you sound good because you've had a great, great run at MTSU that continues. So one of the fun things about our commencements is I get to hear the banter between the deans. So y'all kind of, you know, talk a little to each other back and forth. And you and Dean Fisher of College of Basic and Applied have a little bit of thing going on about who graduates the most.
The most students.
And I think you're still number one, right?
Still number one, and he even had to admit it in front of the president on spring. But Bud and I go back and forth as to who has the largest college.
Well, and you've got a large college because you've got great programs. Why don't you talk a little bit about the programs in your college?
Well, we have 24% of the student body in the College of Behavioral Health Sciences and 15% of the faculty. We have programs in criminal justice, health and human performance, human sciences, psychology, social work, and nursing. And within those, there's different areas of emphasis. Like, for example, in criminal justice, matter of fact, I always keep my driver's license pretty close to my MTSU identification card because most of the police officers in the Middle Tennessee area have gone through our program at one time or another. But we also have a homeland security operation there. Human sciences is amazing. They have fashion merchandising, mm-hmm. textile design, interior design, family and consumer sciences. So there's a lot of things that people can study in that. Health and human performance has got exercise science, which is a really popular major, athletic training, which I might elaborate on later. It's also have recreation, leisure sciences, and tourism, which if I had known you could major in that when I was a young man, that's probably what I would have done. And we have speech, language, pathology, and audiology. Psychology has one of the country's only undergraduate programs in industrial and organizational psychology, as well as regular psychology and a graduate school track. Social work's got a real strong program. I believe that Michael Schur was interviewed earlier on your program, mm-hmm. telling you some of the designs he has. He's got a lot of energy and he's moving us forward in that. In nursing, just got our reports back from the licensing exam. We had 98% of them pass.
That's fantastic. Again, congratulations.
Well, thanks. Yeah, it's all due to the hard work. I have six great department chairs and I've got great faculty.
We talked about this earlier, but there's a common thread throughout your college. It's careers in helping people. Right. And that really resonates with your team, right?
Two things that I ask everybody to keep in mind. Number one, customer service. Mm-hmm. You know, I tell all the students that we work for them, although it's not going to come across that way, but that we call ourselves the caring professions. And when you think about all the different things that I mentioned earlier, from helping people hear better and speak better, to nursing, to, you know, police officers are there to protect and serve. So we basically see ourselves as the professions that actually help people have better lives. Mm-hmm.
Now, President McPhee, when he asked you to start this college, I think he sort of said this was a temporary gig, right? Just kind of get it started. And when was that conversation?
Well, I'll tell you what. First, I agreed to be the interim dean of education and behavioral science until we could get Lana Sievers here, who is fantastic, you know. And then the president decided to start a new college because he really wanted the College of Education to stand alone, as it probably should with our history. So he decided to put together this other college. And I was sitting there one day, and all of a sudden it dawned on me, wait a minute, I just had four of these six programs. So he called me up, and first I said no, but Dr. McPhee is a great persuader, as we all know. I've been here for 45 years, and I'm trying to make this place great. And so I said yes, and that was, we're our eighth year now as a college, and my 10th year as a dean.
You know, in addition to that, you're also serving as the faculty representative for MTSU Athletics, and I know you're very proud of that, and I know that's a labor of love for you. Right. Walk through that a little bit.
Well, I'll tell you what, I report directly to the president on this, but I'm responsible for the academic integrity and the academic programs. And by the way, we just found out this year, we have all of our programs meeting the academic progress rate, the NCAA.
Congratulations.
You know, they work hard. The Student Athletic Enhancement Center works hard. The coaches are behind it. We've graduated like our last 60 basketball players, which at our level of success, and it's just amazing. And football's in the top 10 in the country. We don't take in kids that can't make it. And if there's some question, then we meet. The Vice President for Student Affairs, Deb Sells, meets with me, and we meet with the Athletic Director, Chris Massaro, and then we make a recommendation to the Provost. And so we want to make sure that we get kids in here that can succeed, and they do. Another thing, I'm responsible for student athlete welfare. Is equipment okay? Are they eating right on the road? And we don't have an issue on that. You know, everybody is treated the same. Doesn't matter gender or sport. When you're on the road, you're treated the same. And then I'm the cold-hearted NCAA prosecutor, which is the downside of the job in a way. But again, my job is to protect the integrity of the university. And there are other things that we do that, you know, we maintain the dignity of the people involved. There's always violations. If you don't have violations, the NCAA is starting to look at you. Because there's always these little violations. But anything big, myself and Daryl Simpson, who's our assistant AD for compliance, we're on it right away. And we've gotten really experienced at it. But we have a really good system at MTSU right now. We have what's called institutional control. And when Conference USA came in to look at our operation 2 years ago, they actually used that phrase. And the one thing you never want to be accused of by the NCAA is a lack of institutional control. Mm-hmm. Right now, this is the golden age of MTSU athletics. And in my opinion, it's the golden age of MTSU.
Well, you know, I think that's due in a large part through the continuity and consistency of the leadership for you in that role. But leadership has never been one of these things that you shy away from. I think you're our only two-term faculty senate president, right?
That's right, yeah.
You know, and that's a unique perspective that you bring to all of this, right? Because you've really seen that dynamic, too.
Right, yeah. I was with Dr. Walker, previous president, and I spent 2 years on his executive team and 2 years in the dean's council. And it was very interesting because you get the perspective for the whole campus. I also chaired developmental studies 1 year when a person backed out, and then I was the interim chair of psychology once, and then I get pulled into this dean thing. I used to tell people I'm a Kelly administrator, just... Nobody's there, plug Whiteside in. I don't know if it's because they think I'll do a good job or that I won't be missed when they take me from where I am.
But Dean, you've got to, even with your, what you just said there, you've got to respect the fact that you love this university.
Oh, yeah.
You've served it in so many different roles.
I've spent my whole career here, whole professional career here, so I'm totally true blue.
Yeah.
And nobody can ever question that.
Well, I don't think anyone can question that at all. You are true blue, and you are the campus icon.
I know that. You coined that.
No. I may have.
It comes up everywhere now.
Well, it's because of you. Dr. Terry Whiteside, thank you for joining us on Out of the Blue.
My pleasure, Andrew. Thank you, sir.
And we will be right back.
Do you want the advantages of a major university with the Ivy League experience of an honors college? What you're looking for is right in front of you. Middle Tennessee State University's beautiful campus is home to over 140 majors taught in state-of-the-art facilities. Our undergraduates get hands-on experience, working alongside a highly respected and caring faculty. Take a closer look. Become true blue.
Hey, MTSU Fly Peeps, Bernice Fly Girl Armor coming back at you. Education is the gateway to the American dream. The two proudest days of my life was walking across the stage, becoming a Nashville police officer, and across the parade deck, becoming a United States Marine. MTSU was the gateway to my American dream. Go Blue Raiders, cleared high.
Middle Tennessee football is back. The 2017 season will be a season controlled by effort, attitude, toughness, and turnovers. True Blue fans, the Blue Raiders need your support this year. Tickets are on sale now. Visit GoBlueRaiders.com/tickets and get yours today. Middle Tennessee football, our town, our team.
I love Middle Tennessee. This is a place that helped me solidify my career plans. It's where I made lifelong friendships, and it's where I met my wife. I was very involved in the Student Government Association, the Ag Department, and Greek Life, where I formed connections that I still rely on today. Why don't you help me keep those connections alive by being an active and involved MTSU alum? Go Blue Raiders!
Welcome back to Out of the Blue. I'm Andrew Oppmann. The Blue Raider Athletic Association, or BRAA, is responsible for fan engagement and support of our athletics program. They organize activities, events, and other opportunities for the public to learn more about our teams, athletes, and coaches. And they work hard every day to bring more attention and donor support to the current program and its goals for the future. Bethany Thurston and Justin Morrison join us today on Out of the Blue. Welcome.
Thank you. Thanks for having us.
So talk to me about the BRAA. Give me the 30-second elevator speech on why is it important to join the association.
Our primary focus is to fundraise for the athletic scholarships of all of our student athletes. We have over 350 student athletes. A lot of those are on scholarship, and when they get those scholarships, we are responsible for soliciting funds from donors all over the state and the country to try to pay for their scholarships to come to campus.
So a lot of what you do in the BRAA is making sure that donors and supporters understand some of the great things that we're doing in athletics, and some of those are fantastic events, right? Why don't you talk a little bit about those?
Yeah, absolutely. So the first one that we have coming up is August 11th. It's our annual donor celebration dinner. Last year we had over 800 people come at Embassy Suites. We had Greg Gumbel come out to speak. He was our keynote speaker. You had a band. It was a really great event. Every member gets it at the $250 level and above. It's a wonderful dinner. You get to interact with our coaches, our staff members, our athletic director, members of the university staff. It's just a really good event for all of our donors.
And now that's August 11th, and we don't know who the speaker's going to be, but it's always an entertaining event, right? But there's also the audience that's there too. You get a chance to network with people, right?
Absolutely. I mean, the people that were there last year are some of Murfreesboro's finest. Mm-hmm. You get, the mayor's there. Everyone really comes to make a great night for MTSU.
And I really think that's one of the most important things about the association, because it allows Blue Raider faithful to connect with people that share their passion about the athletics program and the university, right? I mean, we provide those kind of opportunities.
Right, we have various events that do that. I mean, we just completed signing day back in February. The Blue Raider faithful are there, and you get to interact with all kinds of people from Murfreesboro who just support the Blue Raiders. Mm-hmm.
And then on the 25th of September, don't we have a Chuck Taylor golf tournament, right?
Yes, and that's a great event because someone from that tournament will go to Pinehurst to play in the Acura Alumni Challenge. So, that's a great fundraiser for athletics. It's been going on for a long, long time.
You know, there's been some changes in the BRAA. Whit Turnbow, the senior associate athletics director, is now, I would say, shepherding the association. The two of you are really going to be the feet on the street and the face of the association. But we're also reaching out to prospective and current members of the association with our tickets and the ticket packages, right? So this is football. Why don't you talk a little bit about what folks will be receiving in the mail starting this month?
Yeah, so we're excited this year to do something different with our tickets and parking. We're going to deliver those to you in a new and exciting format. It's going to be a nice binded piece with Middle Tennessee artwork. It's going to have the stadium diagrams, parking maps, FAQs, anything you need to know of what's in the stadium, it'll be in in this booklet, along with your season tickets and your parking passes.
And that strikes me as one of the things I know Witt's talked about is increasing the level of communication with the BRAA members. And some of that requires a little bit more reach out through email. Some of it's building upon some of the great things that we've done previously. Talk about the importance of that community we want to build in BRAA.
Yeah, well, we have a donor base of about 1,600 folks. So we want to make sure that when they hear news, they get it from us first and not from another source. So to make sure that they get their news and all the information from us, we started to do a kind of a game day email we send out for football and basketball for all of our donors, just letting them know, you know, what time Raider Walk is, what time the gates open, or if you need to wear black or wear blue mm-hmm. to the game. And people have gotten We got a really good feedback on that. It keeps people informed. We got channel the game is on, what time the game is.
That importance of community and keeping people connected to the university, that's important not only to increase their level of participation, but also to make sure that we talk to them about the goals of the university, right, and where we want to take athletics. What does the BRAA do in that message? How do we let people know where we want to take the program?
Yeah, we have mighty large goals for the BRAA. We want to see it increase to 2,000 members, $2 million next year. Obviously, this year is already better than it was last year, and next year we want it to be the same. The majority of our donors know the importance of giving to scholarships. Don't know if they see the full circle of facilities, community support that our student athletes are going to need. I mean, on top of scholarships, we provide our coaches with recruiting resources, things of that nature that someone from outsider might not see that we need. I think just the engagement of the community and the communication with our BRAA donors makes them realize like where we are and where we need to get to.
You know, obviously with the success that we enjoyed with the men's basketball program, the prominence that we got in national media, we've taken Blue Raider athletics to the next level. The BRAA also wants to take its membership to the next level and increase participation and engagement. Why don't you walk me through about what our goals for the coming year?
Yeah, Andrew, I like that you said next level, because funny thing is last year we actually did a mini campaign talking about, you know, get us to the next level. And that's always our vision, is just take us to the next level. And next year we'd really like to see the BRAA membership base grow to 2,000 members. We'd like to see $2 million. It's important that our donors realize the significance of their gifts when it comes to athletic scholarships, because those championships wouldn't have been won, like you said, in March Madness, without their gifts. You know, those scholarships wouldn't have been provided to those great athletes if they hadn't given to the BRAA. Our donors also need to realize like the importance of continuing to build our facilities, how much that can impact our programs and take us to the next level. So it's just important for us to engage them on where we are and communicate with them on the importance of their gift and just be transparent on where we are and where we need to be next year.
So you've sold me. I want to join the BRAA. How do I do that? How does that work? Where do I go?
Sure. So the easiest way is probably to call our office, 615-898-2210. We're there 8 to 5 every weekday. If not, you can also go online to our website, blueraiders.com/BRAA, and we have all the different options there for you to pick from. And if you're on campus, you can stop by our office in the Murphy Center.
Well, Bethany, Justin, thank you both. Thanks for everything that you do for the Blue Raider Athletic Association and our university. And we are looking forward to a great season of the BRAA. Thanks for being on Out of the Blue.
Thank you.
Thank you.
And we'll be right back.
Do you want the advantages of a major university with the Ivy League experience of an honors college? What you're looking for is right in front of you. Middle Tennessee State University's beautiful campus is home to over 140 majors taught in state-of-the-art facilities. Our undergraduates get hands-on experience, working alongside a highly respected and caring faculty. Take a closer look. Become true blue.
Your MTSU Alumni Association has a goal of placing this pin on the lapel of all those who call this campus theirs. Let's pass that tradition on.
Let's pass it on.
Middle Tennessee football is back. The 2017 season will be a season controlled by effort, attitude, toughness, and turnovers. True Blue fans, the Blue Raiders need your support this year. Tickets are on sale now. Visit GoBlueRaiders.com/tickets and get yours today. Middle Tennessee football, our town, our team.
It's more than a school, more than textbooks and classes, more than lightning bolts and a diploma. It's a pride in who you are and where you're going. From my baby Raider days to my collegiate years, from the White House to Congress, I've never stopped being proud and where I call home.
Pass the tradition on.
Pass the tradition on.
Pass it on!
Welcome back to Out of the Blue. I'm Andrew Oppmann. As MTSU's Director of Undergraduate Admissions, Linda Olsen and her team of academic recruiters and counselors logged more than 64,000 miles last year. That's enough to circle the globe almost three times. Linda and her team travel throughout Tennessee and our region to talk about the opportunities that await students on our campus. And thanks to their hard work, MTSU is the number one choice of transfer students throughout Tennessee and the largest undergraduate university in the greater Nashville region. Welcome to Out of the Blue.
Thank you.
So you're an alumna of this university.
I am. I have my master's degree from MTSU, so it's been a great opportunity to come home and represent my institution for students looking to come in.
And that's something special, right? Talking about your alma mater to prospective students who want to attend the alma mater, right?
It is. It's exciting to offer the opportunity for an institution that I believe in, is part of me, and share with students with enthusiasm.
Well, it's wonderful having you on campus, and you've already made a huge impact. And one of those things is the True Blue Tour. Now, I know it's been going before you got here, but we've ramped it up a couple of notches since you've been here. Why don't you talk about how we've expanded it?
Sure. So we have, last year we had 11 stops on our True Blue Tour. Throughout the state of Tennessee, we ventured into Georgia, into Kentucky, and into Alabama. And this year we're adding a 12th stop in Birmingham, Alabama. It's an opportunity for the president to meet and greet students. We invite alumni, students, and parents in the area. We host a counselor luncheon to provide updates for people who are working with students and enticing them to come to MTSU. Mm-hmm. It's a lot of fun to watch Dr. McPhee really work one-on-one with the students. And not very many college presidents, university presidents, are out there meeting with students. So what an opportunity to really see our university up close and personal.
It's really MTSU on the road. I mean, that is our senior administrators, all of our counselors, and it gets a little crazy, giving away some gifts, a little scholarship action, right?
It does. It's a great opportunity because we are the only university on display, so all the academics can be specifically highlighted. And Dr. McPhee likes nothing better than to give away money.
It's fun. And, you know, obviously, though, the goal is to get students from across the state when we go to East Tennessee and West Tennessee and, of course, here at home to come to campus, because we really feel the greatest selling point of the university is getting you on the campus and talking with our faculty. Why don't you talk a little bit about the experience that students can have here on campus when they visit?
Sure. It really is important for a student to walk on campus. You learn a lot just in the atmosphere. When a student walks onto campus, they will either feel, yes, this is home, or no, this isn't my fit. We have done a lot to upgrade our campus tour experience. Our campus visits start with a display of some of our singer-songwriters in action, live students performing their original music on campus. Then they march into our tour room where there's a world-class video that talks about all our academic programs, what to do to get into the university, and a little bit more about the particulars about the admissions process. And then student leaders and tour guides take the students and their families out on a walking tour across the entire campus. Like I said, when a student walks on campus, there's an overall feeling of, this is it, this is where I want to belong.
You know, we talk about that in our marketing, take a closer look, because we have such a large alumni base, and many of those alums are sending their kids to the campus, and they may not have the most recent picture of everything that we've done on this campus, more than $800 million in improvements just in the last 10 years. So one of the things I love about that experience that you've created is that you can really, in a very short period of time, learn some of the greatest things about this university and why it's a great value and a great opportunity. Talk a little bit about the Blue Elite and the folks that are taking them around on campus. How does that work?
The Blue Elite are appropriately named. They are the best and the brightest of our students. They audition, interview, for the opportunity to be our student tour guides. They're very specifically trained. We give them a 2-week training period. They're very prepared to answer student questions on student life, student engagement, mm-hmm. academic programs. They come from all walks across the campus, from the Greek life to the non-Greeks to the specific programs are well represented. So there is a tour guide that can answer most any question from every area on campus. We even go into housing tours, and those tour guides, Blue Elite, are well trained on marching through and answering questions. And we encourage students to ask their questions. What's it like on campus? What do you like about campus? What did you do? Where did you come from? So the student perspective makes all the difference.
I know we on campus take great pride in making sure that we're welcoming to our visitors. Everybody that comes to campus gets a true blue bag that's got their materials. And that's a signal for us on staff that, hey, these are prospective students or prospective student parents. And how can we be more engaging to them? The friendliness of the campus is one of our selling points, right? I mean, I've heard that several times. Why don't you elaborate a little bit on that?
Sure. The blue bags are a simple bag. They put their materials in them. If they have anything special they want to carry along, it's in the bag. Faculty around, department chairs, deans, the president. If they see that bag, they'll stop and greet the students when they come because it is a very warm, embracing community. We like to reach out to our guests. We want the guests to have the best experience. And when you have a dean of a department, if you have Bud Fisher from the science department step out, that's who he is. He enjoys meeting the new students coming onto campus. Dr. McPhee, if he's crossing campus, will always say hello. He loves seeing new faces.
One of the big messages that Dr. McPhee conveys all the time is that recruitment is everyone's business, not just the admissions team. But I do want to do another shout out to the admissions team. They travel so many places and do such a great job. I mean, they are really doing wonderful work in the individual communities throughout Tennessee, right?
They are. We have probably been to 90% of the high schools across the state of Tennessee. We do the standard college fair tour, but our team goes into the schools. They will meet with families. Some of them even have small coffee shop meetings with families who want to know more. We get out and we go as far north, traveling to Louisville, Kentucky. We go as far down as Birmingham, Alabama, south of Atlanta, Georgia. We want to show everybody what we're about. But the big invitation is come see us. Come take that closer look. Come visit us on campus. We'll come to you, but we really want to showcase our university in person. So come see us.
Well, Linda Olsen, thank you so much for joining us on Out of the Blue.
Thanks for inviting me.
And this does wrap up another edition of Out of the Blue. You can find more stories and more videos about the campus 24 hours a day by visiting our website, mtsunews.com. Now, if you haven't been to our site recently, check it out. It's been revamped and redesigned with some additional content from MTSU Magazine and other sources. We also invite you to follow MTSU on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram for additional special content. On a personal note, all of us here at Out of the Blue want to congratulate our former host and current Murfreesboro City spokesman, Mike Browning. Mike earned his second master's degree from MTSU in our spring commencement. We're proud of you, Mike. I'm Andrew Oppmann, and I hope you'll always remain true blue.